We're looking at some Coconino sandstone just above Soap Creek Rapid. And in the Coconino are these really cool tracks. We don't know if they're amphibian or reptile tracks, but some kind of four-footed animal. And you can see the toes right here and the heel back here. And the tracks always go up the crossbed slopes. We've not found any tracks out of the thousands of trackways that are known from the Coconino. None of them go downhill. And the other thing that's kind of curious about the sandstone is the maximum dip is going this direction, but many times the tracks actually go at an angle to the dip, but the claws are kind of pointing up dip a little bit. The tracks are also very nicely preserved. Oftentimes you can find distinct toe impressions and things like that. And there's been a debate as to whether these tracks were made in dry sand, whether the tracks were made in damp sand, or perhaps sand that was underwater. Dr. Leonard Brand has studied these tracks extensively, both in the field and in the laboratory. And in the laboratory, he took an aquarium and he made a sand dune inside the aquarium, filled the aquarium up with water, and then used some amphibians to make tracks underwater. And the amphibian tracks that he made underwater best matched the tracks that are here in the Coconino. Of course, he made tracks in dry sand and damp sand as well, but the underwater tracks were the ones that really show the detail. And because of those kinds of experiments, we think that these tracks in the Coconino sandstone were made underwater. And in fact, Dr. Brand published the research in several reputable journals, one paper even in the journal Geology in 1991. So these are some animal tracks. They're not as distinct as some of the others. Some of the sandstone hasn't been peeled away yet, as you can see here. And two sets, a left side and a right side, are going up here, front and rear tracks. And the animal is crawling sideways up this underwater sand dune. And you can see some of the detail in this track right here. Some of the sand has been pushed back away. Now the tracks always go up the slopes of these sand dunes. We don't see them going sideways. And what we think this means is that there are animals that are underwater trying to crawl to the surface. And sometimes we even see these tracks disappear in the middle of a nice flat surface like this. And so we think the animal might have actually been picked up by a water current. If these were tracks made in a desert, we really wouldn't be able to explain why sometimes these tracks suddenly begin and end. And so based on those kinds of evidences, we think that the explanation for these tracks, the best explanation, is that these tracks were made underwater. Okay, we're wetting these tracks because sometimes the detail shows up a little bit better on the wet rock. And so the sun angle is really nice right now, and the water helps bring out some of the detail that you might otherwise miss. I'm gonna put my scale back in here. Whenever I take a geological photo, I put a scale in there so I know how big it is, and I can work on those measurements right on the computer screen if I need to. Over there we saw the tracks, the lizard or amphibian tracks that were made underwater, and then over this way we see the parting lineation or current lineation on the rock. And this is a feature that I've seen everywhere where I've studied Coconino. It's a very prominent feature in the rock. And the sand is avalanched downhill in this direction. And this kind of parallel pattern that we see in the rock, and see it kind of goes in this direction. This is called parting lineation or current lineation. And this is something that we can see form today. And it does not form in dry desert environments. It only forms in underwater environments. And we have examples in riverbeds and so forth where we see this pattern form. So again, this is parting lineation or current lineation. And this is one more evidence that the Coconino was put down underwater.